This is part 11 of logarithms, and we're going to be solving equations involving logs, and we're going to solve the following three equations in this video. Some of the things you're going to have to keep in mind as you're doing this is the meaning of logarithms, how to change from a log to exponential form, and that A is greater than 0, B is greater than 0. Both of these numbers must be greater than 0, and the base B cannot be equal to 1. And then these four properties are the most commonly used properties when you're solving logs. All right, we need to solve this. Try it on your own first. Okay, so I've got the log of 2x minus 3 base 5 equals 2. So I could just use the definition of logs. What does this mean? It means 5 to the second power equals 2x minus 3, or 2x minus 3 equals 5 squared. Either way you want to write it. I like to write it this way so the variable's on the left. And so now this becomes a simple equation to solve. We just have to square 5. And we need to add 3 to both sides. So we get 2x is 28, divide both sides by 2, and x is 14. Now it's important when you're solving log equations that you plug the number back in and at least make sure that first of all the base is not negative, or 0, or 1, which of course it isn't since it's 5, and also what you're taking the log of, this 2x minus 3, also cannot be negative. So when you look back and you put in 14 for x, you can see that this will not be a negative number. But you can also completely check it by plugging it back into the original. So we're going to check log base 5 of 2x minus 3 equals 2. And go ahead and really plug that number in for x. So we have log base 5 of 2 times 14 minus 3. I forgot to put a parenthesis around that. You have to make sure that's in parentheses. So we have the log base 5 of 28 minus 3. Well, 28 minus 3 is 25. And this is something you could do in your head because the log of 25 base 5 means 5 to what exponent equals 25? And that'll be 2. Now, if it was something you couldn't do in your head, you can get out the calculator and just do the log of 25 divided by the log of 5, and you should get 2. And so on the other side, we also have 2. At the minimum, if you don't go through an entire check, make sure at least that you're not ever taking the log of a negative number. So for this problem, the answer is 14. All right. So try solving this one on your own. Notice it's not written as a single log on the left-hand side, so that will be your first step. All right, so let's do that. Well, we have the log of something plus the log of something else. We can use the product property. That means it's the log of x times x plus 21. Now, notice that only works if the base is the same. And notice you don't see the base. So if there's no base shown, remember that means the base is 10. So if you want, you could write the 10. That's optional. But if you don't write it, you have to at least understand that's what's being assumed. So now we've got the log of something base 10 equals 2. So that something will be equal to 10 squared. So we have x times x plus 21 equals 10 squared. We get that out of log form into exponential form, and now we need to solve this equation. Well, first I'm going to have to distribute on the left, and on the right side we need to square 10. And now when I analyze this, I see that I have a quadratic equation. Well, to solve a quadratic equation, you set the equation equal to 0. And if you can factor, you factor. And if you can't factor, then you could use the quadratic equation, or you can use the square root property, you know, complete the square. But how convenient, this actually factors. So this is going to be x plus 25 times x minus 4 equals 0. So we set each factor equal to 0. So we get two possibilities. X can be negative 25 or X can be 4. Now remember, when you must check both of these in the original. So if we go back up to the original up here, if you plug in negative 25 for X, you're taking the log of a negative number. That's not allowed. So you could go through the trouble of writing it down, but hopefully right away you see that that's not going to be a solution. It's not that X can't be negative, it's that when you're checking it back in the original, you can't take the log of a negative number. All right, now if you put in 4 for X, will we be okay? If we put in 4 here, yes, because we're taking the log of a positive. And if you put in 4 over here, you have 4 plus 21, also positive. So 4 might work. And that's our next step, is to actually check it completely in the original. All right, so let's plug in 4 for X. We have the log of 4 plus the log of 4 plus 21. So that's the log of 4 plus the log of 25. Now there's two ways you can go from here. You could use your calculator and put in the log of 4 plus the log of 25 and add it together, and you should get the number 2 if you're careful. Okay. But if not, you could use your property of logs right here, and you have the log of, remember what this means, you'd multiply 4 times 25, right? So that would be the log of 100. And then remember, even though I didn't write it, these are all base 10. So the log of 100 base 10, well, 10 to what power is 100? 2. So then I can see that I have 2 on the left-hand side, I have 2 on the right-hand side, so it checks. So again, if you want to use your calculator, you could also check it that way. You'll put in log of 4, and then you'll add it to log of 25. Now, if you write down the approximation to your calculator, it will not come out exactly correct because there's some rounding errors that might occur. But if you don't round and you do everything in your calculator, it should come out to 2, probably. So what does this tell me? This tells me that X equals 4 is the solution. All right, see if you can solve this one on your own by putting the video on pause and trying it first. Okay, so again, we don't have a single log on the left-hand side, but we have a subtraction, so we can use the quotient property, the log base 3 of n over 4 is equal to 2. If you want, you can put parentheses around that, it's up to you. So that 3 to the second power, 3 squared equals n over 4, or n over 4 equals 3 squared. So we have n over 4 equals 9, and then you can just multiply both sides by 4 to solve for n, and we got 36. Now you want to go back up to the original and make sure this makes sense. So first of all, when you put in n, make sure you're not taking the log of a negative number, and you're not, because it'll be positive there. And now let's do the full check. So let's put in 36 for n. The log of 36 base 3 minus the log of 4 base 3. So now, again, you could do this in your calculator. You could compute the log of 36 base 3, which happens to be the log of 36 over the log of 3, or what I think would be easier is to simply use your property of logs here, the log base 3 of, that'll be 36 over 4, right, which is 9. And then what is the log of 9 base 3? That you could do in your head. 3 to what power would be 9? That would be 2. Okay, so you have 2 on both sides. So that means 36 is the correct solution to that problem.